Welcome to Greenfoot. This is a quick tutorial on how to get things started in Greenfoot. Greenfoot is built off the Java programming language and introduces object-oriented programming, or OOP for short, without needing to learn Java just yet. Now, right off the bat, we're given this blank scenario because we haven't created any scenarios yet for Greenfoot. To get a scenario started, we need to start with the scenario button. Click New Stride Scenario. Once you click it, what will happen is it will tell you where it wants to save it. I'm fine with saving it in Documents, but I need to give it a new name. So rather than writing at the end, I'm just going to write the whole write in the word Tutorial and hit the word Create. Greenfoot closes and boom, a new window opens up. Now, I'll bring this back into focus. Right now you can see that there's a lot more stuff on this page. You have my world here, you have world, you have actor, and you have this blank white canvas to work on. To do anything with this, all we need to do is right click. So I'm gonna move this to the side because it will go off the screen. Right click, and it'll say set image. So let's set the image. A window will pop up and you have already a load of images that have been saved into these system. Let's go to background, let's go to a checkerboard, and I'll hit OK. So now I have a checkerboard image on my background. Simple. Let's say I want to put something on this checkerboard. So I'll go to right click actor, new subclass. A new window will open up, and now let's say this time I want to put a, let's see, we have a ladybug. Let's put a ladybug. I'll click the ladybug, but you notice how it does the OK button. Doesn't let me click. Why? Well, if you look up here where the flashing cursor is, you'll see the red lines are not a valid Java class name. So, I will need to give a valid Java class name, which means this all needs to be one word, ladybug, and I'll hit OK. The OK button is now available. I hit OK, and you'll see that the ladybug is ready. If I want to add the ladybug to checkerboard, all I need to do is right-click ladybug, it will say new ladybug, and I can put it right onto the checkerboard. Let's say I do not want to have to right-click the new ladybug every single time I write something. All I can do is hold and press and hold shift, and I can put as many ladybugs as I want onto the screen. Make sure that the box is highlighted, so the black border is around the box that you're choosing. If I want another actor, all I need to do is go to new class. Let's choose people. Oh, Blue Jay. How about Blue Jay? So Blue Jay. And you'll notice how it wipes the slate clean every single time we do something. So we want to be careful with that. There's my Blue Jay. There's my ladybugs. Now if I hit the word act, nothing happens. Why? Well, because I haven't told Ladybug or Blue Jay to act. So to that, I need to double click Ladybug. Wait for it. When Ladybug's up, you notice how it has act right here. It has act right here. You do not need to understand what it means to override method in actor. That is a Java thing. We will cover that as we go along, but not right now. There's a whole list of things here that will be shown and are hidden somewhat. You do not need to know what these are just yet. We will go through them one by one. On the right side, you have a list of things you can use. Now, these things are there to help you. You don't necessarily have to use them, but if you do use them, it makes your life easier. So right now I wanted to move, so I don't see the move button here. So I'm just going to go call method and I'll click it. And you notice how it has typed in some of the code for me. It also gives you examples. Move 3, move forward 3 pixels, turn 5, turn right by 5 degrees. All these things here are to help you code. So let's say I want to move. You cannot click the move. What you can do is go type in the word move and literally type in, I'm going to do 10, not 3 in this case. Once that's done, I'll control save. I'll close this window. The slate has been wiped clean. And remember how I changed the ladybug? So I will put my ladybugs on. I also put some blue jays on. And I'll hit the word act. And you notice how the ladybugs are moving and not the blue jays. And this is the key of object-oriented programming. Each object is its own actor, which means each object will follow its own set of rules. Once it hits the edge, it stops. Now let's reset, and let's go with a bunch of blue jays and a bunch of ladybugs. Let's say I don't want to keep hitting act. I'll hit the word run. And that's what happens. When I hit the word run, what basically happens is the computer will call act again and again and again. It is as if it's hitting act for me a lots of times, very, very fast, and shows you the movement of all these images across the board. This is it for the introduction. Have fun. If you wish to download this program, it's called Greenfoot. You will need to go to Google, search Greenfoot, click the download, and choose the operating system, either Windows or Mac or Ubuntu, for your program. And you can download and install. Have fun.